In addition to the many built-in numeric formats that we see in Excel, you can also create your own. Now, I don't want to make this sound like a make-work project, but there could be times when you have a certain look in mind. Some of these might be like what we're seeing in columns E and G here. Let's first take a look at column B, though. Maybe your company uses an ID number, and for years the scheme you've used is, because it's a seven-digit number, it's going to be easier to read if we put a dash in after the third character, between the third and fourth characters there. So, let's create a format for this. Column B is selected. We can go to Format Cells. I'll right-click and go to Format Cells. Remember, Control-1 works also. And we can go immediately to Custom. Now, if you start to scroll through this list, you're probably going to be a little bit overwhelmed. It is not important to understand every single one of these. Some of the larger books on Excel go into great detail about what these different symbols mean. Many times what you'll do if you're looking for a particular kind of format is maybe take an existing one and make a change or two to it. Let's say we wanted to put in a dash here. You wouldn't necessarily know this, but I'm going to type, first of all, three zeros. That serves as a placement holder for numbers. So we want the codes in column B to consist of three numbers, then a dash, and then four numbers, four zeros. Keep an eye on column B as I click OK. And there's our scheme once I adjust the column width. There we go, by double-clicking that right boundary. So we don't actually type the dash. We just type the number. So maybe that number is just dead wrong. I'm going to put in the number code here, 456, and then 3421. I'm just typing those numbers. Press Enter. There's the dash that we want. Now, there is a built-in format for phone. You might want to use that. It contains parentheses, a space, and a dash. But it's not uncommon to see phone numbers with periods in them. So, let's build a special format for that. Control-1 will take us to Format Cells. Let's jump down to Custom. This might be a little surprising here, but we put in, initially, three zeros. That part's not the surprise. Earlier, we saw the example of where we simply put in a dash, and it was in the format. But since we're going to put in a different symbol than a dash, and it's going to be a period, we need to put in double quote, period, double quote. And then three more numbers, 000, and another period. We put that within double quotes, double quote, period, double quote, and four more zeros. Now, I'm going to copy that and display it a little bit larger. You probably can sense what it's about, but not too easy to see. I'm going to press Control C here. But the main idea is we're creating this, clicking OK, watch column C. We see periods there. Not uncommon. I do see that from time to time. You might have also. The format, I'll just display it right here. And of course, this isn't necessary, but sometimes you want to do this. I'll simply press Control V. So that's the actual format that's being used over there. And I'll center it so we can see it a little bit better. That's the format that's being used in column C. So easy to create. And if that's the look you want, fine. Now, when you see formats here, like the ones here, and you like it, rather than trying to figure it out, a good tip might be just click one of these, jump right into Format Cells, Control 1, and move this off to the side, and you'll see the format being used. It's simply general format. In other words, it's not introducing commas or anything else in the number portion of the display, but following that in the actual description out here of the format, asterisk, period. So, without necessarily saying you'd know that, obviously, whatever follows the asterisk will be repeated throughout the width of the cell. And as we look up and down column E here, from E2 down to E7, we see how the number of periods will vary based on the width of the number that precedes it. Now, what if you say, well, I'd like to use something like that, but I want the numbers to follow the dots. Well, why don't we just highlight these and go to Format Cells, Control-1. We can actually borrow from this. Here's the format right now. Why don't we just click in there and wipe out the trailing period and asterisk and just use our arrow keys, go to the left. And what do we want this to begin with? A bunch of periods. So we put in an asterisk and a period and then general format. And we see the difference. And by that time, you probably have the idea. What do we have here? Same general approach, but we've got leading underscores. Once again, pressing Control-1, we see the display right there. There's the asterisk and the underscore, followed by the word general. I wouldn't say, by the way, that general is necessarily the format you're always going to be using here, but we can see how it is being used here. And at different times, you'll see, for example, this kind of format. That looks kind of nice. These used to be called check protect symbols. I'm not sure if they still use that term, but the idea here is someone couldn't take a check and put in other numbers there between the dollar sign and the first significant number. But here too, pressing Control-1, looking at the format there. Now, something else you'll see in here, and I don't want to go on a huge tangent here, but you will see this kind of a structure too. Sometimes you'll see two different kinds of formats separated by a semicolon. When you see two different formats separated by a semicolon, this shows you what the display will look like if the number is a negative. In other words, we're going to be seeing parentheses here. So I'm going to not make a change here. Perhaps what I should do here is just to highlight this, press Control C to copy because I want to paste it in a bit. And I'll just do a cancel here and display this off to the left. Now, because we've got these two formats here, this is what happens when it's going to be negative. So we'll see parentheses there. So I'll make this number be negative. Simply double click, put a minus in front of it, watch the display. So that gives you some other insight into some of these formats as well too. So with the bit of information we've seen on these different kinds of formats, I think you could easily understand how we can get formats like these and like these. Remember, when you see a format you like, consider the possibility. Well, what does it look like? What is that format? Press Control 1, take a look at the format up there. You will see some of these format displays separated by multiple semicolons. And when you have more than one semicolon, for example, if there were another one out here and then another format, that's for situations where you want to have a display for positives and then negatives, and then what happens when the cell content is equal to zero. So there are lots of other formats that we could use. Here's another one out here, not uncommon. This is using leading dots like what we saw up above, leading periods, but this time we're using a format here that actually uses commas. So that was simply created by taking one of the existing formats and simply inserting in front of it an asterisk and a period. So lots of different formats, easy to use for those specialized cases and easy to copy from the existing formats that might already exist there.